Kansas City Chiefs quarterback Patrick Mahomes is the new face of the NFL. After sitting on the bench in his rookie season, he familiarized himself with the team's offense and took the football world by storm. In just two seasons, Mahomes has already won an MVP, a Super Bowl title, and a Super Bowl MVP, but you already know that. Here's 10 things you don't know about Patrick Mahomes. He was drafted by the Detroit Tigers in the 2014 MLB Draft. There was once a time where it was a very real possibility that Patrick Mahomes would never step foot on a college or professional football field. Back in the summer of 2014, Mahomes had just graduated from White House High School as a multi-sport star. That June, the Detroit Tigers selected Mahomes in the 37th round of the Major League Baseball Draft. While he played both ways, his powerful right arm allowed scouts to dream about what he could do on an MLB mound as a pitcher. Luckily for football fans, Mahomes would not be swayed from his Texas Tech commitment, and he remained steadfast in his pursuit of playing football at the highest level. Still, it remains a testament to Mahomes' athletic abilities that Tigers area scout Tim Grieve still considers Mahomes one of the better athletes he's seen, considering he spent decades scouring East Texas for premium baseball talent. He loves ketchup. Everyone has a favorite condiment or two, but Mahomes has a particularly strong attachment to one of America's favorite sauces. In 2018, the Chiefs signal caller made headlines when he told reporters that he preferred ketchup to barbecue sauce on his steaks. Of course, in one of the biggest barbecue cities in the world, Kansas City fans had to forgive their star for committing one of barbecue's biggest sins. Naturally, as Mahomes was on his way to leading the league with 57 touchdown completions, fans were willing to let him slide. His love of ketchup doesn't stop with steak, though. He has said multiple times that he loves it on all kinds of food, even macaroni and cheese. Needless to say, it was not long before the largest ketchup manufacturers in the country were fighting to give him a premium sponsorship deal. In December of 2018, Mahomes made a final decision. He's a Hunt's ketchup man now. He threw a football out of Arrowhead Stadium. Everyone knows Mahomes has one of the strongest arms anyone has ever seen on a football field. In 2019, while Mahomes was playing catch at Arrowhead Stadium, he decided to dazzle us all. From field level, Mahomes loaded up and launched a football over the stadium scoreboard onto the concourse. Yeah, he didn't technically throw it out of the entire stadium, but it remains an absurdly incredible accomplishment. On the field, Mahomes has consistently made 50 and even 60-yard throws look easy, and now we know why. To surpass the height of the scoreboard, Mahomes' throw had to be at least 260 feet in the air, meaning his throw traveled over 85 yards before it reached its apex. The unimaginable feat should give you a new respect for just how much Mahomes is capable of with a football in his hands. It also should give you some more respect for his receivers, who have to catch the passes he flings their way, no matter how much velocity he puts behind it. He's dating his high school sweetheart. Most professional athletes, just like anyone else, tend to have a few relationships before settling down. A few contemptible athletes and celebrities will move on from partners after gaining stardom to pursue more vain ends. That's not Mahomes' story, though. In 2012, during Brittany Matthews' junior year in high school, she began dating Mahomes, who was a sophomore at the time. She would go on to attend the University of Texas at Tyler, where she played soccer. At the end of her collegiate career, Matthews headed to Iceland, where she started her professional soccer career. After helping her team to a league championship in her first year, she decided to step away to live with Mahomes in Kansas City. Since, Matthews has become a certified fitness trainer and became an online fitness and workout celebrity. In 2019, she launched Brittany Lynn Fitness, a website that sells training programs and merchandise, all designed by Matthews. Even though the couple had to deal with long distance for many years, they seemed to find a way to make it work. Today, things seem to continue going strong. They both chronicle their experiences together on social media, and they seem intrigued by the idea of settling down in Kansas City after purchasing a $1.9 million home. I'm sure that's exciting news for Chiefs fans who don't want to give Mahomes any reason to look for greener pastures elsewhere. He was robbed at gunpoint. Sadly, no amount of on-field success or celebrity can save you from being in the wrong place at the wrong time. Before anyone knew Mahomes was going to be the most sensational quarterback in league history, he was just the Chiefs' rookie first-round pick. After the season, Mahomes was back home in Texas when he and three people were robbed by two men who pulled up in their driveway and gestured as if they had a gun. The four victims handed over what they had and immediately called the police. The authorities eventually caught up with the two assailants, and all their valuables were returned. Thankfully, nobody was hurt in the incident, but it surely was a scary experience for Mahomes, and one he hopes to never have to go through again. His father was an MLB pitcher. If you were wondering where Mahomes' arm strength came from, it would not be a bad idea to look at his dad, Patrick Mahomes Sr. Jr. was not the first member of the family drafted by the MLB. His father was a star baseball player at Lindale High School in Texas, but like his son, played well on both sides of the diamond. At first, he was considered a premium outfield prospect, but after being clocked throwing 94 miles per hour on the mound, his future was as a pitcher. The Minnesota Twins drafted Pat in the sixth round of the 1988 MLB draft. Mahomes reached the big leagues just 4 years later and pitched in 11 of the next 12 MLB seasons. While he began his career as a starter, he was quickly moved to the bullpen where his struggles with control were less problematic. Still, Mahomes was never able to limit his walks and finished his career with a mediocre 5.47 earned run average. That wasn't all for his career. Even after he made his last MLB appearance in 2003, Pat would play professional baseball for another 6 years before retiring in 2009. He idolized Alex Rodriguez. If your father plays Major League Baseball, it only makes sense that your idol would probably play baseball too. Alex Rodriguez was an MLB star from the early 1990s through the first decade of the 21st century. Needless to say, his incredible glove work at shortstop and Hall of Fame caliber bat made for highlights that led plenty of kids Mahomes' age to idolize A-Rod. Of course, it's even easier when Mahomes' father signed with the Texas Rangers and became one of Rodriguez's teammates in 2001. His father's relationship with A-Rod gave the young Patrick Mahomes a chance to get to know Rodriguez personally and even get some personal lessons. Hilariously, Rodriguez recalls once telling Mahomes that he was a baseball player and that he should focus on following in his father's footsteps. Oh, A-Rod could not have been more wrong. Back then, fans did not know about Rodriguez's use of steroids and other performance-enhancing drugs, so it would be interesting to hear what Mahomes has to say about his former idol's greatest controversy. He was Max Preps 2013-2014 Male Athlete of the Year in high school. If there's one thing you're going to take away from this video, I hope you realize that Mahomes is an even better athlete than you had imagined. While his incredible performance at the NFL level came as a shock to many fans, in reality, his history should have ensured no one was surprised. We already talked about his baseball exploits in his senior year of high school, when he batted over a .45 while remaining the ace on the team's pitching staff. In one doubleheader, Mahomes threw a no-hitter that included 16 strikeouts in one game, while going 3-for-4 with a home run in the next. His football numbers that season were even more insane. In just 13 games, Mahomes threw 65 passing touchdowns and accrued over 5,500 passing yards. Oh yeah, that's not the end of it either. Mahomes also starred on the White House High basketball team, where he averaged more than 19 points and 8 rebounds a game. His coach said he could have played Division I basketball if he wanted to, considering in two of the team's playoff games, Mahomes scored 37 and 49 points respectively. It's hard to doubt his coach's comments. He broke the NCAA record for total yards in a game. Do you see it yet? Mahomes was always destined for stardom in whatever sport he picked, but it's hard to imagine anything could have approached his abilities on the gridiron. At Texas Tech, Mahomes was the team's starter by the end of his freshman season and never looked back. In his third and final season in college, Mahomes threw 41 touchdowns against just 10 interceptions, while amassing 5,052 passing yards in just 12 games. Plenty of moments were memorable over his junior year, but none more than the Red Raiders' October matchup against Baker Mayfield and the Oklahoma Sooners. While Texas Tech lost 66-59, Mahomes tallied 819 total yards before the final whistle blew, on an absurd 88 passing attempts, Mahomes tallied 734 yards and 7 touchdowns. His legs added another 85 rushing yards, the final touches to a showing that should go down in history as one of the greatest single-game performances in college football history. He broke the Madden curse. Yeah, you can talk about the touchdowns, the awards, and the championship, but we have seen plenty of players reach those heights before. However, Mahomes is the only player ever to be put on the cover of EA Sports Madden video game and win the Super Bowl the following season. In fact, there was a time when players feared the Madden curse so much that the company has had a number of prominent players decline the opportunity. Take a look over previous Madden cover athletes, and you'll see plenty of players whose careers were derailed by injuries, legal run-ins with the criminal justice system, and just plain old poor performance. When Mahomes missed time with a leg injury last season, many fans were crediting the curse. Of course, no one's saying that now, after Mahomes returned and led Kansas City to its first Super Bowl victory in 50 years. So, where do you think Mahomes' career will go from here? And you think anybody else in the NFL can step it up to match his gameplay? Let me know in the comments down below. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. Thanks for checking it out. We'll catch you next time.